Okay. Trust is very important factor for all relationships. So, pinaka importante sa atin. When trust is broken, it is the end of relationship. Lack of trust leads to suspicion. Suspicion generates anger, causes enmity, and enmity can result in separation. Okay? So importante that we have to trust. Telephone operator told me that one day she received a phone call. She answered public utilities board. There was a silence. She repeated PUB. There was still no answer. When she was going to cut off the line, she heard a lady's voice. Oh, so this is PUB. Sorry, I got the number from my husband's pocket. But I do not know whose number it is. Without mutual trust, just imagine what will happen to the couple if the telephone operator answered with just hello instead of PUB. Okay. And the second is what we call right speech. There's a Chinese saying which creates the meaning that speech will either prosper or ruin a nation. Kaya mag-ingat tayo sa mga salita. Many relationships break off because of wrong speech. When a couple is too close with each other, we always forget mutual respect and courtesy because we may say anything without considering if it would hurt the other party. A friend and her millionaire husband visited her. Their construction site, a worker who wore a helmet, saw her and shouted, "Hi, Emily, remember me? We used to date in the secondary school." On the way home, her millionaire husband kissed her, "Luckily you married me. Otherwise, she would be the wife of a construction worker." She answered, "You should appreciate that you married me. Otherwise, you will be a millionaire and not you." Frequently exchanging these remarks plant the seed for a bad relationship. It's like a broken egg cannot be reversed. So be careful with our speech. The third is no overpowering. Many relationships fail because one party tries to overpower another or demands too much. People in love tend to think that love will conquer all. So their spouses will change the bad habits after marriage. Actually, this is not the case. There is a Chinese saying which carries the meaning that it is easier to reshape a mountain or a river than a person's character. Mahirap. No? Madaling baguhin ang river. It is not easy to change. But setting high expectations or changing the spouse character will cause disappointment and unpleasantness. It would be less painful to change ourselves and lower our expectations. So there are these relationships that we talk. Now we don't have to change one another, but we have to accept one another. Okay? We don't have to change, but to accept. Okay? So the fourth is creating perfect relationships. A person visited the government matchmaker for marriage, as do you, and requested, "I'm looking for a spouse. Please help me to find a suitable one." The SEU officer said, "Your requirements, please. All good looking, polite, humorous, sporty, knowledgeable, good, singing, dancing. Willing to accompany me the whole day at home during my leisure hour if I don't go out. Telling me interesting stories when I need companion for conversation. And be silent when I want to rest." The officer listened carefully and replied, "I understand you need television." There's a saying that a perfect match can only be found between a blind wife and a deaf husband. Because the blind wife cannot see the faults of the husband, and the deaf husband cannot hear the nodding of the wife. Many couples are blind and deaf at the 13 states and dream of a perfect relationship. Unfortunately, when the excitement of love wears off, they wake up and discover that marriage is not a bed of roses, but a nightmare. Okay? So, maybe. No pointing fingers. That's a relationship. A man asks his father-in-law, "Many people praise you for a successful marriage. Can you please share with me your secret?" The father-in-law answered and smiled, "Never criticize your wife for her shortcomings, and when she does something wrong, always bear in mind that because of her shortcomings and weaknesses, she could not find a better husband than you. We all look forward to being loved and respected. Many people are afraid of losing face. Generally, when a person makes a mistake, they look around to find a scapegoat. Personal perception. Different people have different perception. One man's skin could be another man's poison. A couple bought a dandy from a market. On the way home, a boy commented, "Very stupid. Why neither of them ride in the dandy?" Upon hearing that, the husband let the wife ride on a dandy. He walked beside them later on, and an old man saw it and commented, "The husband is the head of the family. How can the wife ride in a dandy when the husband is on foot?" Hearing this, the wife quickly got down and let the husband ride in the dandy. Farther on the way home, they met an old lady. She commented, "How can the man ride on a donkey but let the wife walk? He is no gentleman." The husband thus quickly asked the wife to join him on the donkey. Then they met a young man. He commented, "Poor donkey, perhaps at the present and never will be in the future. Thus, do not be bothered by words. By other words, if our conscience is clear." Kaya huwag tayo padadala sa mga kung nasabi-sabi ng mga kasama natin o sino nga sa mga Jericho, kasi hindi na mangyayari sa iyo. Okay? Kanya-kanyang personal plan tayo. And then, be patient. Okay? This is a true story which happened in the States. A man came out of his home to admire his new truck. To his puzzlement, this three-year-old was happily hammering dents into the shiny paint of the truck. The man ran to his son, knocked him away, hammered the little boy's hand into the palm as punishment. When the father calmed down, he rushed his son to the hospital. Although the doctor tried desperately to save the trust.